Rabindranath Tagore, also known as Bard of Bengal, was born on 7 May 1861 in Kolkata. Steeped in culture, pen and paper as his voice, a writer, playwright, composer, philosopher, a social reformer, painter, and best known as a poet, was the first non-European writer to be awarded the Nobel Prize for Literature in 1913. Gifted Tagore was a prolific composer with approximately 2,232 songs to his credit. He believed that nationalism could not rise above the values of shared humanity, and this meant to him more than honor and accolades. Through his works, he continued to help people dream of a better world, even in the darkest of times. Tagore breathed his last on 7 August 1941. Ladies and gentlemen, this evening we are gathered here in commemoration of Bharat Ratna Sri Rabindranath Tagore's 161st birth anniversary.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to Timothy. First of all, then I urge that supplications, prayers, intercessions, and thanksgiving be made for everyone, for kings and all who are in high positions, so that we may live a quiet and peaceable life in all godliness and dignity. Heavenly Father, your Son Jesus reminded us to pray for those in authority through his apostle Saint Paul. He taught us obedience to the civil laws and also to obey God's laws by telling the people to give to Caesar the things that are Caesar's and to God the things that are God's. Matthew chapter 22, verse 21. We pray for those in power that they may fear you and serve you, and always remember that they are your representatives and ministers of your justice. We ask you, Lord, to grant them divine wisdom to govern the people wisely and justly like King Solomon. Lord, we ask you to raise up good and selfless leaders who will make laws to protect our freedom so that all can live peaceful and quiet lives with dignity, that they may awaken our country into that heaven of freedom where all can live without fear and hold our head high. As we commence this choral competition of National Anthem, we come to you, Lord, invoking your presence, assistance and divine grace upon our Honourable Chief Guest, the Organising Committee, local political leaders, and upon all the participants and also the audiences gathered in this place. May this coming together increase our unity and promote national integration, peace and prosperity of all the citizens. We made this prayer to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
One of his kind, here, not only here in our state, but in our country, because I have not come across any even that national anthem singing competition was held. I welcome all the dignitaries, participating colleges, party workers, the media, and all present in this house. BJP is grateful for your presence. BJP is thankful for your presence. For any event to be a success, we need attendance and we need participation. And when invitation for this event went out to colleges in and around Kohima only due to logistic and technical issues, the response was very good. And because of the response, we were encouraged even more to take the competition to a higher level. I'm very sorry to inform the House that our chief guest and our party president, Sri Temjan Innak Along, he had to leave for Guwahati this morning along with our chief minister, our deputy chief minister, and a host of other of our state leaders due to issues. So on behalf of the party, my apologies, and I wanted all the participating teams and the dignitaries present here to be aware of that. I believe he was the first Indian to win a Nobel Prize. He's a Nobel laureate, and we are proud of him. And hence, BJP Nagaland is organizing this program to honor him and to celebrate the 75 years of our freedom. I wouldn't be wasting too much time. The participating colleges came quite early, so I'm sure they are very eager to get up on the stage. And I, on behalf of the party, once again welcome you all and wish all the participating colleges all the best. There will be 3 winners, but let us all go back from this event thinking thinking that we are all winners, and we wish that on my own behalf, once again welcome you to this event, and wish the thank the faculty and the participant colleges, the judges, for being here with us. Thank you all together. Let us make this even a thing to remember.
Punjab, Sindh, Gujarat, Maharashtra. Once again, welcome you all and extend a very thank you to all for this positive response and participation to this National Anthem Carol Competition and commemoration of Bharat Ratna Rabindranath Tagore 161st birth anniversary and in commemoration of the 75 years of Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav. Till this morning, our chief guest was very eager and was looking forward to attend this function. But due to the unavoidable state issues that has arisen and which demanded his physical presence in Guwahati with a very heavy heart, he departed for Guwahati. And as such, he sincerely, from the bottom of his heart, expresses his forgiveness for his inability to attend this program. Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav is an initiative of the government of India where all of us are involved. Initiated by India to celebrate and commemorate 75 years of independence and glorious history of its people, culture, tradition, religion, and achievements. This Mahotsav is dedicated to the people of India, including you and me. Thus far in its evolutionary journey, but also hold within them the power and potential to enable the vision of a free India. Our most renowned Bharat Ratna, Sri Rabindranath Tagore, his contribution, his efforts, his achievements, his sacrifice for the nation building is immense. And as we celebrate his 161st birth anniversary, I, on behalf of our Honorable Minister, challenge you to be a responsible citizen of this great nation. Responsible citizens who can contribute to this great nation, be it in your village, be it in your colony, be it in your town, district, state, or nation at large. In every little possible way, in whatever possible way, I challenge to be a contributor, citizen of this great nation. Students are gathered here from 10 institutions, renowned colleges and institutions. It is like a privilege to be studying here in the capital city of Kohima, where during the Second World War, the first battle was fought in this very soil, where the history, course of history was changed. Japanese forces were trying to enter the mainland India, capture the Mapur railway, airport and all, and then to penetrate the mainland India. But it was halted here in this very soil. We are very much privileged to be studying here in this town, the capital of Nagaland. Be an ambassador of the great city, being an ambassador of this small state of Nagaland, and be a contributing citizen. Jai Hind. Thank you so much, and our Honorable Minister has prepared dinner for all of us. So after the program, you may kindly join us together with the assembled dinner. Thank you so much.
Bharat Jaya Hai, Bharat Jaya Hai.